let me tell you a story. I just got a tetanus booster and I did not have a choice as to whether I could refuse it or not. And you know about everyone's like, I'm being forced to have the COVID vaccine. Like, honestly, like, just shh, just be quiet. So I had to get a tetanus shot. I did not have a choice. Well, I had a choice in the beginning until I didn't have a choice. So basically what happened was, last night I spilled boiling water on my foot. I was wearing a sock. So basically I spilled boiling water on my sock. And in the time that it took me to be like, oh shit, and like put the pot down and rip my sock off of my foot, the water was so hot that my skin slid off of my foot by the time I got my sock off. Like, once my sock came off, it looked fine. And then I put like water on it and then like all the skin just came off. So, because I'm me and irresponsible, I actually don't own like a first aid kit at my house. Like, no band-aids, no nothing. So the only thing that I had was paper towel and KT tape. So after I ran under cool water, I like waited a bit, and then I put some ice on it after that, and I took a shower, and at the end of the night before I went to bed, so that I wouldn't stick to everything when I was sleeping, I put a paper towel around it and then I wrapped it in KT tape. So today I went to urgent care to get a COVID test because one of my coworkers at one of my other jobs happened to get COVID. Don't know which one it is. I just got a text that said someone had COVID. So while I was at urgent care, I was like, hey, you know, while I'm here, could you like give me medical attention for my foot burn? And they're like, well, do you want real medical attention or do you just want a band-aid? And I was like, well, if you have the time, I would really love for you to take a look at it. But if you just have a band-aid, that's fine. So basically, the physician comes in and she like does some testing to see if I have muscle weakness because I have COVID or whatever. And I let her know about my foot. And she was like, oh, well, you know, like, you're a little out of date for your tetanus booster. If you want, we can give you a tetanus booster today. And I was like, okay, no problem. She cuts my bandage off of my foot. She looks at the burn and she was like, get me the tetanus to the assistant. And he like went out and had to go get it. So it became me not really giving them an answer, being like, yeah, maybe we'll see, to her being like, no, you're getting this vaccine today because this is a bad burn. And so I got it. It actually like hurt a lot, like, ow. Right now I feel okay. I feel like a little bit of like strain, like right here, like soreness. And I feel like I'm like clenching my jaw a lot. And honestly, I feel like I did this the last time I got the tetanus vaccine when I was like 17, that I was like, I have lockjaw now that I got the tetanus vaccine. So like, I'm like slowly remembering like my last update experience, and it was very similar to this one. So right now it's just really like arm, like my arm hurts, like where I got the injection, and I have like a little bit of soreness here. And then my jaw feels kind of tense. But other than that, I'm okay. They also referred me to a burn clinic because they were just like, you might want to go get this looked at by someone who's not like urgent care. And I know like urgent care is literally like Starbucks or McDonald's. And really the only thing urgent care is good for is to do your COVID tests and tell you if you're dying or not. And that is actually something that some of the specialists that I've been to have told me. They're like, all urgent care is good for is to make sure that you're not gonna die. So I personally don't feel like going to the burn clinic. I think that I have enough first aid knowledge as like a previous volunteer EMT in my past life of my teens that I really think that I'm going to be able to take care of this burn by myself. And in the event that there is a complication, I can go to the burn clinic. But I don't think it's really that serious. So now I have been forced to get this vaccine that I kind of honestly didn't really want to begin with. But it's for the greater good, and it's to make sure that I don't get lockjaw and die. But honestly, like, it's been maybe like 18 hours since I like spilled this on myself, and I feel like if I were to get tetanus, it would be like before that, maybe. I don't know. But yeah, and also, like, I looked up the tetanus booster dosage on the Googles, and the dosage that they gave me was not the booster dosage. It was just like way more. I'm assuming as a precaution, which is fine, whatever. Like, what's more tetanus booster gonna do to me? Maybe, I don't know. We'll see. Anyway, so yes, I have been standing here for the past like 5 minutes, and people have walked by, and it's been really awkward. So that is my story for today. So until next time, I'll see you guys later. Bye.